Hello everyone, this is a part 2 of an explainer video on French Revolution brought to you by Navodaya Foundation, Mysuru. In this video, we will see the outbreak of the revolution and the following consequences due to the French Revolution. We have already seen in the previous video about why the treasury of the state was empty. And due to this, the emperor Louis XVI was thinking of ways to increase it. But France had a system in which no emperor could alone take a decision to increase the taxes. And to decide upon this, there was a political body termed as Estates General Assembly. Now, let us understand the structure of Estates General Assembly. In this body, all the three estates about which we have already discussed were represented. And there was a rule in this Estates General Assembly that was, each estate had a single vote. Thus, a representative of each estate cast a vote on the behalf of his estate. And the second important thing to note here is about the functions of the Estates General. The functions were to impose, decrease and manage taxes. And though the monarch alone could not decide upon the imposition of the taxes, he alone could call or summon the Estates General. Thus, the King Louis XVI summoned the Estates General on 5th May of 1789. But on his summoning, there was differential number of representatives for each estate. The first and second estates had 300 representatives each, but the third estates, which consisted of normal people, had 600 members. And moreover, the seating arrangement was also such that the first two estates had seats and they were facing each other, but the third estate members had to stand. And another important point to notice here is the women, peasants and artisans were not invited to this Estate General, and they had to convey their problems to be presented before the Estate General via the representatives from the third estates. Now, there was a strange contradiction there. We have to understand the taxation burden was already on the third estates. And another point to notice, the voting system which gave single vote to each estate resulted in the first two estates commanding a majority. Thus, somehow or the other, the entire taxation burden, if it was imposed, was to fall on the third estate. This contradiction was not acceptable to the third estate. So, the third estate suggested a change in voting system from what was prevailing, that was one estate one vote, to one member one vote system, which is also termed as independent voting system. And via this system, first estate had 300 votes and the second estate had 300 votes and the third estate had 600 votes according to the number of representatives put forward by them. So they suggested a change in the voting system. But the new voting system suggested by them to the king was not acceptable to the king, as it went against the interests of first and second estates, whose support was extremely crucial for the king. So, as this was not acceptable to the third estate members, they walked out and gathered in an indoor tennis hall and proclaimed that until they form a constitution, they will not move out of the tennis court. And they called themselves as National Assembly. And this National Assembly was led by two leaders, Mirabeau and Abbé Saïs. Mirabeau and Abbé Saïs, who both belonged to privileged classes, that is, first and second estates, but were sympathetic and upheld the rights of the third estate's members. Now, we have already seen about the food riots that were happening and about the insensitivity of the King Louis XVI and his queen, and about the Bastille riot that happened. These events were happening parallelly and subsequently in the backdrop of formation of National Assembly and the storming out of the third estate. This was followed by a harsh winter, which actually the deterioration in the social order. And it was followed by a harsh and violent treatment of members of the first two estates to the extent of many of them abandoned their homes and left France. Thus, in order to pacify the Third Estate, the monarch, Louis XVI, took few steps like recognizing the National Assembly, thus legitimizing it, and also said whatever the Constitution declared, the King would abide by. And few other changes were also introduced on August of 1789, which included the privileges of First and Second Estates were abolished, the clergy was also made to pay taxes, the taxation powers of the church were abolished, and land owned by the church now was confiscated by the king. Thus, in France, there was a shift from monarchy to constitutional monarchy. This was followed by few political changes, that was, power was divided between legislative, executive, and judiciary. The legislature now consisted of National Assembly, and the executive consisted of king and the ministers, and the judiciary constituted of judges, among whom power was divided. And along with this, a system of limited voting was also introduced, wherein men who were above 25 years of age or who paid taxes worth of 3 days of labor wages were termed as active citizens and they could vote. Thus, it introduced a system of active citizens and passive citizens. And another important event that makes French Revolution remarkable is the Declaration of Rights of Man and Citizens, which came into being via the National Assembly, which upholds the human rights of the citizens. Thus, in this video, we have seen how the Estates General was formed and how the National Assembly came into being and the subsequent changes that were seen in the political and social sphere. In the next video, we will see how constitutional monarchy was transformed into a republic in France. Hope you have understood. We will be shortly coming up with the third part of this video. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe our channel. Thank you once again.